experience with Hurricane Ian. We're still seeing some sea turtles out here this morning. In fact, here's one right here crawling along the beach this morning. So we've seen quite a few of these out here. But, you know, this is just a sign of hope as Sanibel continues to rebuild. But there's something that's really important here, because the slight change of a storm's path can really have a drastic impact on storm surge. NBC2 First Alert meteorologist Jason Dunning is in the studio with more.
Thanks, Alan. I like to say that when it comes to tracking tropical systems, miles matter, particularly here with the state of Florida, the way it's shaped. And a lot of times when we get impacted by storms, they move parallel to the coast. That tends to be the angle of approach. That was the case going back to Irma. That was the case with Hurricane Ian. So this was the forecast cone the day of landfall, and you can see Ian out in the Gulf of Mexico. And of course, we knew the path that it ended up taking as we look at the path right into northern sections of Lee County, Roncalio Costa, and right into Charlotte County. But let's say that Ian started off, let's say, just about 30 miles here farther to the west from that launch point, and that would have made a huge difference in terms of the impacts that we see, just that slight wiggle or a wobble. And as we kind of play that scenario out to show you what that would look like, that would have been on the western side of that forecast cone. So instead of a landfall over Lee County, we would have seen a landfall closer to Bradenton and Tampa and St. Pete. Still would have seen impacts here locally across Southwest Florida, but not as major. So when it comes to hurricanes, miles matter. That's why it's very important to pay close attention to every forecast as it gets closer to time.